I'm Katie McCall. Imagine this. You're still without power, but your bill still comes in the mail, and it's way more than you typically pay. That's what one Duke Energy customer says happened to him. So we put Jeff Preval on the case to find out what's going on.
A Duke Energy spokesperson says that these bills were issued in error to only St. Petersburg customers. Today, I spoke to one of those customers who says that his bill tripled in cost, and he says he's not paying.
The storm knocked out Jeffrey Jalinas' power on Saturday. Since then, he and his family have been running appliances off a generator. So they're staying cool, but when Jeffrey saw his family's power bill skyrocket to $600, he couldn't believe it.
It's normally about $200 to $220 a month.
Where did your eyes go when you saw that amount?
they went like bulge out of my head pretty much. I mean, that was a lot of money.
I spoke to a Duke Energy spokesperson about how this happened.
We're in all hands on deck mode with restoration, so we're not able to read meters. And so when we're not able to read meters, we estimate bills based on previous month's usage.
But how is that possible? Remember, for Jeffrey's family, their bill is usually around $200.
We don't know. So because we started hearing the customer's comments and because we are so focused on restoration, we stopped the process.
What's your message, I guess, to Duke Energy?
To Duke? I mean, my message to Duke is just, you know, have a little bit more like foresight next time, you know, like looking exactly like what you're sending out to your customers.
Now, if you think you have one of these bills in error, Duke Energy says that you should not pay it. Late fees, they will be waived. And they say that a representative should get out to read meters next week. If you have auto pay, Duke Energy says you will get a credit. Back to you.